Hello, you are welcome to our video tutorial. In this tutorial, we'll explain you car manufacturer administration. This is a VB.NET project. This project will be useful for BE, BTech, BCA, Diploma, or for all computer science students who are supposed to do a project for their curricular activity. So you need to find a new project or new idea. So this is a one idea. For car manufacturer, we can make one project. So in VB. So this one we developed in VB, but you can do it in C Sharp. You can also do the same project in Java. You can also do this project in Python. You can also make Android app. You can also make web application. So once you know the concept of this project, you can implement in a different languages. Therefore, watch the video till end, then you'll get a clear picture. So from that, using that idea, you can improve the project or you can make different projects, all possible. Fine. So let us understand what exactly this project is. So here is a car manufacturer. They manufacture cars. So they manufacture different models. So this is one model, this is another model. So now to manufacture this, they require employees. So there are employees. So employees will manufacture the cars. So what are the cars you manufacture? We need to send to the showroom. So here is a showroom. So we'll send the vehicles to the showroom. So in order to manage all these things, we require a software. So therefore, in the software, there should be provision to enter all the model details. Model 2. Provision to enter the employee details. Provision to enter the showroom details. So provision to enter what are the manufacture done. So how many manufactured. Then how many sent to the showroom. Sent to the showroom. So all this we want to track in this particular software. But in practical, car manufacturer required a very huge project. But this is the beginning. So this is a small project, mini project. In order to serve the purpose of car manufacturer, we done this project. So after watching this video, maybe you get a clear picture. So based on that, you have to prepare the project. Software requirement. So this is the requirement for this software. Now let us look at the project forms. What are the forms we are using in this project? So here we are on 16 forms actually. So one is destination form, so which will be utilized in the employee detail form. An employee list. So we can enter all the employee details in the employee form. And this list is to show the employee list. Goods in report. So goods in is like how many we manufacture, that we need to take a record that go to goods in. Goods out, so what are the cars we have manufactured that we want to send to the showroom, so that we want to enter, and this will go to the goods out form. And the corresponding report, so we'll show the report in this particular form. Login form, MDA form, and module, these are the common things in every project. So login form to login through this form. MDA form to have a menu and navigating the rest of the forms. Module is to declare global variables. So qualification form, again, what are the qualification enter, that will be reflect to the employee detail form. Showroom details, we can enter all the showroom details via this form. Showroom report, so what are the entries done here, that report will be shown. Then vehicle details, so individual car details we can enter through this form. Then the welcome screen. So welcome screen is the beginning screen. So these are the forms we are having in this project. Now let us look at the tables. What are the tables we are using in this project? So we are using around 8 tables. One is car details, to store all the car detail information. Designation, qualification, and employee. This is the one group. So therefore, qualifications and designations will be reflected in the employee form. So then all these data go to the employee detail table. SA main, SA detail. What in and out, so vehicles in and out, so that both will be stored in these two tables. showrooms, all the showroom details will be stored in the showroom. User table, so where you have a login credentials. Based on that, we compare what are the entry you done in the login form, and if both are valid, so we can able to log in. Fine. So these are the tables which you are using in this project. So project demo, I'll demonstrate the project for you, how you have done this project. So after that, probably you get a complete picture. So before getting into demo, we request to subscribe to our channel. Therefore, we can bring you more videos. And also, if you like this video, click the like button. And if you have anything to say, please write in the comment box. And also, these videos are very useful for all the computer science students. Therefore, please share this video with your friends and family members, so we can help more people. Now I'll show the project in VB. So here you can see that all the forms are there here. And here is the database, and these are the tables which you are using in this project. So let me run this project. So Maxcar is the title given for this project, and that is the company name. So you can change any company name, no problem. So admin, admin. So single module project. Here is the main entries, qualifications and profession. Here you can enter all the qualifications, what employee have the qualifications, that we can enter. And what are the destinations of the employees, that we can enter it here. Then here it comes, car detail. You have to click the new button, car model name, introducing date, what date we are introducing, what is the basic price, colors, facilities, engine type, what engine type it is, and then mileage, how much mileage it will give. Other details you need to enter. It will be something like this. You need to enter all the details like this. And then you have to save. You can also modify this record, and you can able to delete the record. Then employees. So you can click new button again. Employee short name, Kiran. We can give even code also. But here not to remember easily, so we give name with a mobile number. So this is Kiran Kumar. Fine. So I just take only mobile number. Rest of the data we can fill later also. So when you come to education and destinations, you can see that what are the entries already done. So here it will be reflected, or it will be listed in the list box. So we can choose one from them. So consolidate salary. So let's say 45,000. Right. So save this data. So the record will be saved, and it will be displayed in the grid view. Next is the production. So production means when manufactured. So okay, if the car readily manufactured, then we can enter it here. So here we can enter the number, voucher number, center. So we take a production center, item code. There is a vehicle, Bharati Baleno. So here is the quantity. So today we manufacture 100, and if click card. If other models also is manufactured today, we can add into this voucher only, and we can save. It means that now 100 quantity will be added to the stock. Next, showrooms. So what are the showrooms are there? We can enter all the showrooms here. Sales. So now we need to sell this car to the showroom. So we select the showroom data here, and then item code. So this is the car. And here you can enter ton we want to send to this showroom. So therefore, this ton will be deducted in your stock. Save. So we done one sales to the showroom. These reports we can able to see here. Showroom list. If I click display, we can able to see all the showrooms. If you click production report, it'll show like how many car manufactured. And here it shows that what are the sales we done. The list will come. Then employee list, all the employees who are working with us, that list will come. So that means what are the employees you already enter here, that automatically will come here. Okay, this is again data grid. We also given the provision to print. If we click print, it will be get printed, and we take the paper print out. Fine. So these are the options which are provided in this project. So hope you got an idea. So based on that, you try to write the same project in VB or C Sharp or in Java, right? So in case if you're looking for any of the project from our channel, please contact us. Thank you for watching. So again, don't forget to subscribe. Please subscribe to our channel. Therefore, we can provide you more videos. Thank you once again.